What was different about Italy compared to all the other places you lived?
When we went to Italy, we came from America.
Okay.
We've been in America for 2 years, and in those days, we went to a small village in Italy. Things were very different. The village did not even have a supermarket. And of course, in America, when I went to the supermarket, I could buy meat, packaged meat, and I knew how to prepare it. But in Italy, there were butcher shops, and there was half a cow or half a pig, and I had to point out what I wanted, and I had no idea how to prepare it. Or they had chickens hanging there, and you got the whole chicken, they took the feathers off, but you had to take the head and the legs off.
How did you travel from the US to Italy?
How did we travel? We did not immediately travel to Italy, but we took the boat to come back from America to Holland, because in those days flying was very, very expensive, and it was cheaper to be on the boat for 8 days than it was to fly. And also, being on the boat for 8 days is a lovely holiday. I don't know, have you ever been on a boat for a longer time? It's lovely, and the food is very good, and there were lots of parties on the boat, and we had a great time, and it was also a possibility to relax and to think about going back. And then when we arrived in Holland, after 3 months, we went to Italy, and that was by car.
The next question is, what can you take away from your time in Italy?
What did we take away? What did I take away from my time in Italy?
No.
Oh dear, lots of very nice memories. You know, of course, that Italy is a beautiful country, and also we live very close to Rome, so we had a chance, we lived there for 4 years, to see many, many things that normally you don't see because a tourist goes there for 1 week. And we traveled a lot, we saw beautiful places, and nature is very nice, and the people were nice, and I learned Italian quite well. I still have friends that we got to know when we lived there, so yes. And Alessandra, your mother, was born there, which is of course a very nice thing to take away from Italy. So it was a lovely time. I've got lovely memories when I think about it.
Summarize how excited or bored you were during the flight.
Oh dear. Well, we were all very excited. We couldn't believe it could really happen. So everybody was sort of in a fever about, is everything going all right? And are they still on track? And does it look okay? And are they going to survive? And what's going to happen when they really land? You know, you can't imagine what it was like because it had never been done before. So, yes, we were very, very excited.
Did you follow the first journey to the moon?
Oh, yes, because we had no television. And we lived in a house with three families. There was a couple at the top of the house. Then there was a very big part of the house where the owner lived. This is my two children, and then down, not really the basement, but in the lower floor, we lived. And so the family, the owners, invited us all to followed the landing on the moon at that television. And your mother, Alessandra, had just been born. So she was still a very small baby. So I sat there with your grandfather, Gal, and Judith, who was four, and your mother, Alessandra, as a baby, and me, and we all looked at the moon landing. It was very exciting.
Is there any relationship that you have with the space agency?
We did at the time. We had a relation to the space agency because your grandfather, Kalt, was working for the European Space Research Institute in Frascati, which at the time was one of the offices of the European Space Research Organization.
How excited are you about people flying to Mars?
Oh, that's a difficult question. Of course, we are excited to find out more about the whole universe and about all the discoveries that are being made at the moment. I don't know whether there's a lot to learn from Mars, but yes, it's exciting.
Peter, how did you experience the moon landing?
In the Navy in those days, and my mates, my comrades and I, we sat in a pub, because the pub restroom was the only place that had a TV set. It was all in black and white. And we watched it, and we couldn't believe it, and we had a couple of jars, meaning a few drinks, on the success of the moon landing.
I'm going to step off the limb. That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.